Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mudula Bapat, Consultant Radiologist at Dhanvantri Diagnostics and Bapat Urology Center, Thane, India. The focus of my interest is diagnostic and interventional ultrasound, and the aim of today's presentation is to highlight the normal sequential events which occur in the early first trimester. I hope you enjoy the video. I hope the video is beneficial, especially to those who are beginners and have just begun their first trimester ultrasounds. The aim of this presentation is to highlight the normal events that occur sequentially in the early first trimester. We all know that the first trimester is the period of rapid changes that begin with fertilization, formation of the blastocyst, implantation of the blastocyst, the embryonic period, and the early fetal life up to 12 weeks. It's important to identify the normal sequential findings occurring in the early first trimester to establish a diagnosis of a normal viable pregnancy. It's important to recognize the ultrasound findings of pregnancy failure and also know the findings which are suspicious but not diagnostic of early pregnancy failure. So, as we all know, it begins with implantation of the blastocyst. The blastocyst is a structure lined by trophoblasts and it contains an inner cell mass. So this structure literally erodes the endometrium and implants, which is when picked up by ultrasound as early as 4 weeks as a tiny rounded cystic structure within the uterine cavity. Now this, as it grows, is seen as an eccentrically placed implanted gestational sac. So we can see here that the central white line is the collapsed uterine cavity and the gestational sac has embedded itself within one of the leaves of the endometrium. So this is rightly called or described as the intradecidual sac sign, which helps us distinguish between a simple fluid collection, which is also labeled as a pseudogestational sac. As you can see on the left, a pseudogestational sac is a more of an oval or an oblong collection which is right in the center, and you really don't see the collapsed uterine cavity, whereas a gestational sac is more eccentrically placed and you can see the central white line, which is the collapsed uterine cavity. The next sequential finding is the appearance of the yolk sac by around 5 to 5.5 weeks. The yolk sac is an important structure as it, once identified, it confirms an intrauterine gestation. It's a regular cystic structure with a reflective rim and usually does not exceed 5 to 6 millimeter and is an important structure in predicting outcome. So next to appear in line is the embryo at around 5.5 to 6 weeks, which is seen apposed or closely juxtaposed with the yolk sac. This is often referred to as the yolk sac embryo complex. Now this, which we see on ultrasound, can be very well correlated with embryology, wherein you see the yolk sac cavity very much in contiguity with the embryonic disc. Now we start seeing cardiac pulsations. These can be seen as early as with a CRL of even 2 mm, the lower limit of which is 100 beats per minute, and this should be documented on M mode. So as we proceed to around 7 weeks, you see a sort of a featureless echogenic disc, which is the embryo, and around it you will see a thin white membrane, which is referred to as the amnion. So further, the yolk sac now separates and becomes extra amniotic, and the amnion is beautifully visualized around 7 to 8 weeks gestation. So from a featureless disc, you get a more of a human form by 10 weeks, wherein the limb buds are visualized and the spine is also more definable. So to sum up the events which occur in a normal early first trimester is, first, the appearance of the gestational sac, wherein you see the intradecidual sac sign. If you don't see the intradecidual sac sign or if you have any doubts, it's always better to follow up. Following the gestational sac is the yolk sac, which develops. Then you see the yolk sac embryo complex, which reveals cardiac activity, that is, the embryo reveals cardiac activity, and thus you have an established early pregnancy. So knowing the normal events, we now move on to diagnose early pregnancy failure, and what are the criteria to be applied. Now, all these criteria are from the Society of Radiologists and Ultrasound Consensus Meeting 2012, which gives clear-cut guidelines as to how you're supposed to report a first trimester ultrasound. Our aim is to prevent any inadvertent loss or termination of a potentially viable pregnancy. Many a times when we scan, we find empty gestational sacs, or we don't see an embryo within a gestational sac which is showing a proper decidual reaction. So it's prudent to use a cutoff of 25 mm as the diameter with no visible embryo in diagnosing failed pregnancy. So any mean sac diameter less than 24 mm without an embryo as your first scan, you should not label it as pregnancy failure, but you should ask for a follow-up. Then coming on to your crown rump length criteria without cardiac activity. So whenever you see a CRL which is less than 7 mm and no cardiac activity, it is always better to follow it up, because no heart in a CRL less than 7 mm is suspicious, though not diagnostic of early pregnancy failure. So on to your left, you're seeing an image, which is my first scan. I see a gestational sac with a yolk sac. I've established that this is an intrauterine gestation, early gestation, but then I don't see the embryo. So it's always advisable for a follow-up, and 2 weeks later, I still see no embryo. I only see the yolk sac. So then this becomes a time-based criteria to call it a non-viable gestation. So only on one single scan, wherein you're seeing the yolk sac but no embryo, you cannot label it as a non-viable pregnancy. So guidelines for transvaginal ultrasound diagnosis of pregnancy failure in a woman with intrauterine pregnancy of uncertain viability. So what are the features diagnostic of pregnancy failure? A crown rump length of equal to or more than 7 mm without a heartbeat. A mean sac diameter of 25 mm or more and no embryo. Absence of embryo with heartbeat 2 weeks or later that showed a gestational sac without a yolk sac, and absence of embryo with heartbeat 11 days or later after a scan showed a gestational sac with yolk sac. The findings which are suspicious but not diagnostic of early pregnancy failure include a crown rump length less than 7 mm with no heartbeat, a mean sac diameter of 24 mm with no embryo, absence of embryo with a heartbeat of 7 to 13 days after the first ultrasound showed a gestational sac without a yolk sac, and absence of embryo 6 or more weeks after the last menstrual period. An empty amnion, an enlarged yolk sac, a small gestational sac in relation to the size of the embryo, all these criteria are suspicious but not diagnostic for early pregnancy failure. So it's important to carefully read these guidelines before reporting an early ultrasound in the first trimester. So this is one case of very less fluid or very less lyca seen around the embryo, wherein you have a very small sac, and this should prompt you for a follow-up and not just label it directly as something very much non-viable. So you often see large yolk sacs. We had this case recently wherein the embryonic length was only around 4 to 5 millimeter. There was a large yolk sac accompanying, so no cardiac activity seen. We obviously know that these features are of bad prognostic significance, but it's always helpful to follow these patients up. And this patient, when she turned up on follow-up, was already bleeding, and there was no gestational sac seen inside the uterine cavity on the subsequent follow-up. So it's important to remember that you have features which are suspicious but not diagnostic, and they must prompt you towards a follow-up. And a single scan with bad prognostic features must never be used to label early pregnancy failure. So our aim and our take-home message is it's very, very important to avoid any inadvertent termination of a potentially viable pregnancy. It's important to take into account the sac size criteria, the crown rump length criteria, and very important, the time-based criteria to label a pregnancy as non-viable. Thank you for your kind attention.